Perhaps the greatest challenge facing a civilization is surviving its infancy. We ourselves struggle with that as we try to grow past the age of nation-states, warfare, and the need for weapons that can cause our own extinction. But once past that infancy, for many civilizations, our own included, there lies a future problem that will confront us in our old age. That problem is the life cycle of stars. Our own sun will begin to present problems for our civilization in only a few hundred thousand years. The first of these will be the general and slow brightening of the sun. Though if we're sufficiently advanced, this particular issue would be somewhat easily mitigated with star shades and advanced technologies for harvesting and controlling the sun's energy. Past that period, however, it gets more difficult as the sun will eventually swell into its red giant stage. That end may be avoidable. One area of futurism that isn't yet well explored is the possibility of managing, manipulating, and even refueling ancient stars. Alternatively, there are also hypothetical possibilities regarding the repositioning of planets as the red giant's habitability zone migrates outward. But no matter what a civilization does to mitigate the effects of a star's life cycle, eventually available materials becomes a problem, and the further along in time, the more this problem will assert. So for very ancient civilizations nearing the end of the life cycle of their star, or indeed the end of the universe, solutions for the problem of power generation become limited. Conventionally, one might turn to very long-lived stars, such as the M-type red dwarfs. There are no shortage of those, and they will be among the last living stars in the universe. But there is another possibility, one that lies in our own sun's future. It's hard to envision us as a civilization sticking around in this star system when the sun finally goes red giant and ultimately to a white dwarf stage. We'd need to manage a truly enormous planetary nebula that would form after the sun sheds its outer layers and the solar system's remaining planets reorganize themselves as the sun loses mass. But once that stable white dwarf does form, or we colonize any of the myriad white dwarfs that will be around towards the end, then there is a way to support a civilization using the energy of that stellar remnant. It's a special type of Dyson Sphere laid out in a 2015 paper by Ibrahim Semiz and Salim Ogur, link in the description below. This concept is noteworthy because it not only offers a way to build a Dyson Sphere around a white dwarf, but it also avoids some of the pitfalls usually associated with building a full-on Dyson shell. More, this type of white dwarf Dyson Sphere, if any exist right now, would be very difficult to detect at a distance and might potentially explain why we haven't seen any Dyson Spheres in the universe so far. It could turn out that the only practical type are those built around white dwarfs and are simply too small to detect. White dwarfs are tiny. Our own sun, when it reaches that stage, will be roughly about the size of Earth, though far more dense. This means that the habitability zone of the white dwarf is much closer to the star, so you don't need an enormous sphere to encompass one. It only needs to just be big enough. Smaller spheres are easier to build and manage. In the paper, the researchers calculate that you'd only need a thickness of about a meter for the sphere, dramatically reducing the amount of material needed to construct it, as opposed to a classic Dyson sphere built around a main sequence star. Less than the material contained in our moon, in fact. A smaller sphere also makes Earth-like gravity possible, which is a problem for larger spheres. The one drawback, however, is that less energy is available. A white dwarf emits far less energy than a main-sequence star like the Sun. While it should be enough energy to sustain an advanced civilization if they were frugal, it would be low enough energy not to emit much infrared, the gold standard for detecting Dyson spheres. Given that we're dealing with a universe that's currently bursting with stellar energy, these types of tiny spheres may not yet be common. It would seem to make more sense to colonize high-energy stars, at least for civilizations that behave like us, though if a civilization doesn't need much energy, which is a possibility, they may choose to go this route. But in the far future, when energy resources become scarce, these kinds of Dyson spheres might become common as outposts of life in a dying universe. We may even have our own. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.